Now, Tom O'Brien.
Wow! Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Of course, let's make it a great night, folks. Okay, what do we have out here? Oh, baby. Watch out. Watch out for what? Watch out, folks, for King Dollar. King Dollar out here, no doubt, broke topside once again today. We're at 83.06. The King Dollar is trying to get into 83.65, folks. That's where that baby wants to get into. That would be a 100% move of a move. We did 28,000 contracts out here today. Big number. Bonds. What do we do with the bond market? Bonds go topside once again. That 160 is getting closer and closer. It's pretty amazing. There's no two ways about it. We're at 149.21 right now. Now, what the 149.21 did today is this. Now, yesterday you're pushing highs on volume. Bottom line blows through those highs today with volume. Today, on the 30-year, you did 637,000 contracts. That was taken out the 559. So now what you have is this. You have a daily ABC, a monthly, and a weekly ABC, all going to 160 on the 30-year bond. You know, huge, huge numbers. On the 10-year bond, right? 10-year bond, forget it. That had broken out first. 10-year bond today, 10-year note, rather, did 1.5 million contracts. That took out the 133.27 with monster volume. That's what it did, okay? So what we did here is that the low of that one is 127. You can take the top of 133. You can say, okay, add another $5 onto that. What does that get you? That gets you 138. You know, now if we take, if you want to see something that's pretty wild, I'll take this on, and I'll put this on a TYM. I'm going to put this on a continuous contract for you. First, I'm going to do the... I'll put the 30-year on a continuous contract. So, the 30-year on a continuous contract, right now, with 149.21, what you're going to see is this, is that you're over the highs of 98, and now, folks, what we just launched is that this week, you launched the highs of 2008. And, you know, bottom line, you get 160 on the agenda here. Now, what really is wild is this. Let me just see something. Because another way to gauge this, too, I just want to see what this is going to shape up to be. If we gauge this and we just do a channel line, let me see how far I can get this out. Okay, this is going to get interesting. So, if I do a channel line, okay, so check this out. Okay, so the gauge at 160, how I got the 160 in the first place, folks, was this, is that the measurement is that you take the highs and lows of the large consolidation. The consolidation that we had been in, by the way, okay, was a 10-year consolidation. So when if you're pressing up to them and you have, you know, volume behind the move, okay, you take that consolidation and you just double that consolidation. And that's where the 160 came from. That's the first time the speculation of the 160. Now what we have is that you have a B point that was taken out with volume that's giving you the same number, though. Okay. So now watch what else. When you can do channels, channels take years to form, folks, okay? But all channels are walls that like to contain these different numbers as the market bounces up and bounces down. Well, when I just did this channel here, this is pretty wild. Let me just do this one more time. Because when I just did this channel here, it gave me 174. But if I do this as strict as I can do it. Okay, so check this out. When I look at a channel, the channel actually brings you to 168.08. Now that 168.08 really makes sense. Why? Because the 160 is only a one-to-one structure. And the way that we're moving is telling me that we're going to do more than a one-to-one structure. When you're moving with force like we're moving, you know, it likes to extend the move. You know, so we'll see where that shakes out. It's certainly a big one. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Well, I know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay. 19 points, we come down. Well, guess what, folks? Bottom line, you pull back with 766 million shares. And guess what? It's coming into 1.1 billion shares. You're going to need more juice in order to pull into lower prices. My takeoff right now is that you got into the 1310 area. The high of that was 1312. You're still going to bounce. You're going to bounce to 1340, 1350 in the S&P. That's on a short-term basis. This is a much larger ABC structure on the way down, folks. Dow Industrial, same setup with the Dow. Dow got deeper into the trading day of the last low out here, which was in the 18th. That last low was generated at 12,336. We got to 12,396. Same setup, though. It's going to need a lot more juice in order to break that level. NASDAQ Composite. What the Composite did, Composite came down, also hit the highs of the low bar, and did it with 1.6 billion versus 2.7 billion. You can see you're 1.1 billion shot in the NASDAQ Composite in order to get to lower price. So that setup also, you got to remember something. The NASDAQ Composite came down from 3,100 straight down to 27. You're talking about a move. That's, let's see, yeah, it's $400, 15% move, okay? So bottom line, you can expect a bounce. Now, let's go the euro. Our Tigress, Angie in the den wants to talk about the euro. So let's pull up the euro. Euro, toasted, roasted. Okay, that's the real bottom line. Now we're at 123. The euro is going to 119. That's how it's set up, you know. So you get that low out there. I mean, it's 119, 118 is basically saying, hey, that's where it wants to go. We'll see if we get a bounce along the way, if it builds some strength along the way. You know what it's going to do. Yeah, my take on the euro in general, folks, is that yes, it is done. Get out the peanut butter, get out the jelly, get out the cream cheese, and get out the toast and put it on it because, you know, it just, you know, this is just in common sense. So check this out. And the thing that's wild, folks, that I always, and this is, anyway, well, I'll cut to the chase here. Every time that I've seen that folks turn around and say, if you remember, the euro is going to take over the world. And depending on how long you've been listening, I remember, you know, I've told the story a dozen times, right? When I was, you know, just growing up in Boston, I remember the first oil going up. All of a sudden, you know, all the Arabs, the Middle East was going to take over the world. They had bought up all of State Street. Well, you know what ended up happening? Well, folks, everything tanked. They lost all of it. Then it was the Japanese. The Japanese came in. They were buying the whole United States. Guess what happened? They tanked it all right? They lost everything, right? Now what was supposed to happen is that then China was supposed to take over the world. Well, give me a break. You know, the China deal's a joke. Because you're talking slave labor, folks. You're talking communism. You're talking all of the above. The people in China want to leave. They want to live in the United States or Canada, okay? Want to go to South America? Great place to go, but they'll take your property. Want to go to Europe's a beautiful place, folks. But see, my take on Europe, now this is interesting because I actually did a huge amount of business over there. I did a huge amount of this guy I did business with, the chairman of the board of Wembley Corporation, folks, Sir Brian Wolfson, an unbelievable guy. He really taught me a lot. I was only 30 years old. I did a huge amount of business with him. But what I really learned more than anything was that was in order to operate businesses over there, you had to be totally tied in. In 1980, do you know how long it used to take to get a phone? Just a phone, and I'm talking about in London, which is beautiful. It would take 6 weeks just to get a phone line. 6 weeks. So picture something. I'm 30 years old. I'm doing business in a huge way in the United States. You're doing big deals. I go over there, and as soon as I saw it, I said, well, this is interesting. I was in, you know, with... He was very powerful, so what ended up happening, I could do plenty of business. But if I was ever by myself, there's no way you could operate businesses. No, it's not even close. So I figured out then that the huge economic powers that already taken over Europe. You know, and particularly in the property market, the people that own property, they were there for two or three generations. My point more than anything is, right, there's only one United States. And everyone wants the dollar and everyone wants to be here. We're going to be right back.